Hey everybody, Dr. Knuckle here with eSleep Wellness, here with another tip. We have been on a roll with melatonin, so I had more things to say about the environment of your bedroom, but before we move on to that, I just have one more thing that I would like to touch on that very much ties into melatonin and the light dark cycle that we've been talking about. And the last one we talked about was about having a dark room. But on the flip side, a very important trigger for shutting off your melatonin is to have light. And so that's what today's tip is about, is exposing yourself to bright light during the day. And this has, it's one of the biggest triggers for us maintaining alignment with our environment. So usually, so we think of a typical day as 24 hours, precisely 24 hours, and our circadian rhythm is, we think of being 24 hours as well. Well, we are slightly off from 24 hours for our circadian rhythm, and it's actually 24.2, which means if we were in a dark cave and we never saw the external environment, that means that we would every day drift out of sync with the environment. Now, fortunately, we don't live in a cave, and so we expose ourselves to daylight, and that the little, you know, drift that we would have had, we easily correct, and we stay in sync with the environment because of the light, and then again the dark, and when it comes nighttime. So the key is to, as soon as you wake up, to expose yourself to bright light as soon as possible. And it should be, sunlight's the best. You can use artificial light. It's not always possible to get sunlight. Some days are cloudy, and especially in the winter months, you don't get the sun as bright or as often as you do. So artificial light is fine as long as it's bright light, but we'll get to that in a minute. But you want to expose yourself to bright light, and that will help turn off the melatonin that you've been producing overnight, and it will switch you into a new gear. Now you'll ramp up cortisol. Now cortisol does have a bad reputation, because that's the stress hormone, but it is for healthy amounts. I mean, you still have to have cortisol, and it will increase alertness, and it was like a stimulating hormone, and you'll have increased cognitive abilities once you wake up and switch off the melatonin, switch onto the cortisol system. And then you really should have light throughout the day, but as the day wears on, you don't want to keep that. If you're exposing yourself to bright light at the end of the day, you're going to end up having the opposite effect of what you want that sunlight to be doing. Really should be in the morning and through the day. And research shows that people who have their windows open and let sunlight come in through the day sleep better at night. They have more consolidated sleep. They actually fall asleep 22 minutes faster than people who don't, and they report higher sleep quality. And another study actually in the heat of COVID showed that people who went outdoors for an hour or two, or at least were exposed in a bright room for an hour or two of bright sunlight, had lower anxiety and had less sleep complaints and sleep problems. So it is not just good for waking up, it actually does help that night in terms of getting the sleep that you need. Now, I talked about how artificial light would do in the event that you can't have sunlight. You've heard me say bright light, so you may be thinking, well, will any light do? I would argue the brighter the better. Sunlight's the best. But if you have to do artificial light, you want it to be bright light. Now, in the previous one, we had talked about how blue light, we are more sensitive to blue light. And that actually applies again. So blue light is, up there in terms of being able to give you the effects that you want. And as we talked about, that's like your, from your screens and, you know, cell phones, computers, whatnot, all of those things. And so at the right intensity, as long as like broad spectrum white light was bright enough, then it would have to be blue light. At that point, there's a negligible difference. But if you can't get, you know, intense enough of just artificial white light, then blue light will do the trick. And you want to have at least 30 minutes of light exposure, preferably as close to waking up as possible, so you can help switch those hormones. But like I said, ongoing daylight helps. And then switching as the afternoon approaches, you know, if you have to go for a walk, like take the dog out for a walk in the afternoon or like evening. And if it's in the summer and the sun is still shining bright, then wear some sunglasses or something so that you can start to make that transition. And then we haven't talked about vitamins yet, but, as a side note, 90% of our vitamin D is made from sunlight, so it was endogenously. So you have the perk of making vitamin D at the same time. So that is the one for today. So make sure you get your sunlight, and I'll see you next time.